All right, guys, we're going to go ahead and install llama.cpp, which is a command line inference engine. It is so cool. I love doing stuff on the command line. But it's a little bit of a difficult project. It's actually the basis for many of the user interfaces that you're going to use. You actually don't really need llama.cpp if you're going to be using these other user interfaces, but particularly if you're going to be doing your own projects and stuff, this is going to be very handy. It's also fun to play with. So let's go ahead and we're going to rock on over here to the internet, and let's see if I can get my browser up here. All right, so we're going to do a web search for llama.cpp. Hey-o! Okay, this is one we're going to grab. Okay, the Gurganov. Okay, it's the same guy that made the Cobalt CPP. So we'll go ahead and click on that. All right. Now, this is going to bring up this website called GitHub. Okay, you need to install GitHub before you do this. Now, but when I say you need to install, it doesn't mean you have to install this website, but you need to install software that allows you to interact with it through your terminal. So go over here, type GitHub download. You're going to pull up this here and just click on the desktop one down here and where can I get it, and then you'll get it for whatever. We're going to focus on the Windows. So you would click Windows and install that. So what that does is it gives you the ability to actually interact with the website, with this website. So what we're going to do up here, I just go up here, grab the address of this repository. I'm just going to control C to copy that. Okay. Then what we're going to do is we're going to rock on over to a terminal. Okay. So where's my terminal? There it is. Okay. Now I'm going to do this on the E drive. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to type git clone, and then I'm going to just paste that in there. Okay. So it's all ready to go. I'm just going to hit enter. And voila, starts bringing down all the files through the magic of the internet. So that is downloaded into my E drive. Okay. So actually, if we go over to, not to there, but we go over to here, you'll see that it has actually downloaded the folder, llama.cpp, everything in it. But before we can use it, we actually have to build it. So what we're going to do is we have to go back to the internets, and we're going to look for what's called W64 Dev Kit. So you go to your Google, type this in. You're going to look for this one, Releases Skeeto W64 Dev Kit. So let's click that bad boy. We're going to scroll down to here to the assets, and we're going to download a zip file. Make sure you get this one that has the Fortran on it, okay? So this is the guy we're going to click. So we'll go ahead and click that, and that will download it, and then you put it in your wherever you want. Okay. So once you get it, you're going to download it, okay, and just put it into. You're going to unzip it. This one's on my C drive. I'm just going to go ahead and copy this over here to my E drive really quick. We'll let that get over there. Okay. Once that is. Oh, we're not on the right screen here. Sorry. Okay, here we go. So I've copied this to our E drive. Once you're here, we're just going to click this. All right. And we will open up the dev kit. Okay. It's going to open up this screen here. Let me add that screen there for you. And do we want that is what we want. Okay. So, oh. Sorry, just one moment. Okay, so here we have our W64 dev kit. So I need to navigate to the E drive. So I'm going to type in E. Oh, I forget how it does this. There we go. So I'm going to go CD E. Now, obviously, that would be a bad terminal command in Windows terminal, but for this it works. CDE, we're going to go over there. Then I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to CD myself into the directory llama.cpp. Blap. Okay. Now, all I'm going to have to do is type the magic word make. And it's going to rock through here. Okay, now, while that's doing that thing, we're going to actually go over here. And I want to go look back at this. We're doing a simple build, but when you're building this, you can actually go down here. There's ways to build it a little bit faster if you have NVIDIA. So you can follow these directions here. See, this is just use the make. These are the same directions that we followed. Download the latest Fortran version and then build. Now, there are some build commands that you can use. Here you go, like your blast build. We would want our CUDA build since we have a an NVIDIA card. But so you would type make and then this llama underscore CUDA. We just did make because we're not too worried about it at the moment. So let's go back and see how this is doing. This is still loading up. Okay, I'm going to probably cancel this because I already have it installed. Let's sit for a second longer. So you can see this takes a little bit of time, but good. I'm going to go ahead and cancel it out because it's not that important. That's the process. Let's go back over to where our terminal is, though. Okay, so I'm going to rock on over to the C drive again because I already have this installed here. And let's go into, once you have built it with the W64 dev kit, you go into here and you can see all the files that it puts into here. Okay, I'll show you later. There's some really cool stuff in here for converting models. If you remember with Cobold CPP, you can only run GGUF models. Well, this actually llama.cpp gives us the ability to convert safe tensors into the models that we get. So even if you have a model you can't use, you can convert it into a usable model. So cool. I mean, the guy who built this is Mr. Brain. So what we're going to do is we want to look for this file. It's called main.exe. A simple way that you can find some of this stuff is you just type dir for directory.exe, and that'll show you every exe file that is in there. We want the main one. If you type main and you go dash dash help, okay, it's going to bring up all of the options. Again, this is such a cool software because basically you have to do everything by hand. I don't know why I like that kind of stuff. So these are all your big ones. You can put prompts in there so you can actually set it up. The main things are all we're going to really worry about is loading up our model. So what we're going to do is we have to go find our model first. So let's go on over to our Windows Explorer. I'm just going to go over to here and let's find a model that works good. Let's grab this Llama 3. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to right click on that, and there's an option to say copy as path. So I'm just going to do that. And then we can go back over to our terminal here, and I'm going to type in main. Now you have to put in parameters. Remember, this isn't, you know, extremely easy, but we're going to type in dash dash model, and then we're going to put in the model location. Now, if I hit this with the, with those parentheses in there, I don't believe, yeah, see it's, oh, it actually did work. Okay, so good. But now notice it's giving a bunch of weird stuff. All of a sudden it's just like, this is a placeholder page for Robert Davis. Robert Davis grew up in the small town. Like, it's hallucinating. This is called hallucination. The reason is because we have to prompt it to not. So we're going to go in here. We're going to hit the main dash dash model. We're going to put in our location. Then we're going to go ahead and put a dash dash and type the word instruct, because this is an instruct model, which means that when you're prompting it how to respond, it has a very particular manner in which it receives input, which it puts output. So when we load it without that instruct thing there, it's like a dog off the leash. It's just like, hey, I'm running, okay? So we're going to go ahead and we'll put it in instruct mode. And we'll hit that. You notice it's going to take a minute to, we're going to hit it. It's going to take a minute to load. Beginning of text. Well, here we are. So I'm going to say, Hey there. How are you? And it goes, hi, I'm doing well. Thank you. How about you? Okay. So you'll notice it's going a bit slow. That's because we didn't load it up with the CUDA. We're not doing it with NVIDIA. That means this would actually run off a very slow computer, which is basically what it's simulating here. But through the parameters, we can make this thing really rip up. We're not going to work on that right now, but you could make it answer like that. So let's ask it again. Let's just say, oh, man, I love the Baltimore Orioles. They are so good. Tell me why you love them also. Let's see. I'm glad you like the Baltimore Orioles. Well, I don't have personal preferences. Okay, when it comes to sports teams, I can tell you that many people enjoy the Orioles because they have a rich history in Major League Baseball dating back to 1954. Well, there you go. Team is 3-1 World Series. Okay, so anyway, point being, you can go on. To get out of this, just press Control C. Okay? Oh, let's see if it's going to let us. There we go. Press Control C a few times. It's going to pop us back out. You can play around with it with the parameters. Let's see. I'm not sure. Let's see if this prompt works. Oh, whoops. Prompt. Let's go. I love cats, which I don't love cats, by the way, but I'm going to see if that prompt works correctly like that. Okay, there it goes. So it starts out with I love cats, which is basically like you're prompting the model to start with that. So I say, what about them? And it already knows what we're talking about because we prompted it. We primed it. Isn't that cool? So there's a million parameters in this thing, like we were talking about before. The fun part is getting to learn them all. But we'll have more videos about that. And in the meanwhile, you have gotten yourself going with Llama.cpp, which is, hey, you crossed a big hurdle. You actually compiled a program using a C++ compiler. Dude, you're like right on the path to computer science here. So you hang in there, stay there. Listen, you're going to get there. This stuff is so cool. Ask me questions. If you got questions, I'm happy to help you anytime. And as always, hey, you know, stay good, and we'll see you next time, all right?